Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, only by Nat King Cole. Ring-a-ling-a-ling, Santa Claus is coming, so don't worry. Get in your bed, close your eyes.
Is the season to be true?
Of miracles
and wondrous blessings standing right in front of you.
When I say that phrase to you, the music that made me, is there a song or a musical moment that that comes to mind for you immediately?
Smokey Robinson comes to mind.
It's just my soul responds.
And just being in that musical situation right there with in my home, full of vinyls and full of musical influence from my father, from playing in on the Wilson Pickett tour, guitar, and working with Desmond Dekker and all these musical greats from the 60s.
You mentioned Smokey Robinson right there, this like straight off the bat. So talk to me a wee bit about whether there was particular songs or performances or records, whole albums maybe that by him that were important to your development.
There's this song called A Few Years Ago on My Birthday, I had just become 21. I remember I had a lot to live and a lot to give. Then comes a hand me a gun. Oh, and when on war he sent me to, didn't claim me. If a man in black, the man in black, it's just my soul responding. His soul response. That's what the song is called.
Oh,
yeah.
That is how I normally get to the name of a song. But I can tell you, when I do it, it does not sound like that. That was beautiful.
Sweetheart. Yeah, huge influence. Oh, my God. I met him in Vegas.
Oh, tell me about that. That must have been such a moment.
It really was. I had my little bustier on, and I think he probably thought I was like just a fan trying to kind of like, hi, Smokey. My friend was like, this is Deniece Pearson from Five Side, and you influenced him at her in her career. I just couldn't stop staring at him. I was constantly kissed the album cover till the lips were kind of, it were gone. When I was 13, 14, 15, 16, that, yeah. Yeah, he's my guy.
We kiss all night. I squeeze her tight. Oh, we're kissing cousin. That's what makes it all right.
Elvis was always consistently playing in the house. Mummy was she's a huge fan of Elvis, and she used to play his albums. We used to listen, and then whenever an Elvis movie came on, everybody was together. And we all sat together and watched those movies. All seven of us on the sofa. It was amazing.
Was there one of the Elvis films that particularly you enjoyed?
Kissing Cousins when he was blonde.
Oh, that's an unusual one. What did you like about that?
Back in the day, I always loved blonde. My guy's blonde and blue eyes. And I just loved to see Elvis with the blonde. I've always had this thing inside, you know, when you have this a musical ability and it's a gift and you just keep doing it because you enjoy doing it. It's a passion. And then Daddy started distributing music, and then we had these tons of vinyls in the sitting room. And so we were just always scouring through them. We found the Jacksons, the Osmonds, the Diana Rosses and the Crystal Gales and the Michael Jackson. I just started singing to them, you know, and Coming home from school, I always used to grab my guitar, change from my uniform, grab my guitar to start writing my little songs. So it's in my thread.
It's interesting you mention the Jacksons, because obviously that was the comparison that was always drawn. Were they important to you, or is that something that was put on from outside?
Gosh, yeah, they were important. We used to watch their cartoons on TV. Just like Smokey, Michael has the same thing, you know, in that voice of his. And he was just so tiny and, you know, he's the biggest entertainer in the whole world. Because he touched people's hearts, he made them faint. I got to meet the other Jacksons, the Jackson brothers, on tour. I'll say for the tour, ring me, A, B, C, 1, 2, 3, baby, you and me, girl. And it was absolutely amazing. I got to sing. I finished watching, actually, when I sang the J5 section with Tito. And it was just phenomenal, you know, working with him. I love him. Afterwards, we kind of like, I said, Tito, he smokes these little cigars. So I said, Tito, can I have one of your cigars? And he said, oh, okay. And then I just put it in my mouth. And I says, let's take a picture together. And he had his and I had mine. And we just sort of see. It was like, oh my God, I'm standing next to Tito Jackson. I gotta have faith. George Michael, that's another one who sang from his heart. I love him. I met him in California. It's the first time that I ever saw him properly in the light with his sunglasses off. And it's the first time I saw his gorgeous eyes. He just had this innocence and pureness in his eyes. It's probably why he wore his glasses, you know? Wow, what a beautiful soul.
Merry Christmas to
It's a season of giving, and when people are at their happiest, you know? And I wish every day was like Christmas. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, only by Nat King Cole. The excellence of the pronunciation and the production of the song, and it's very, I don't know, it's timeless, you know? And it's classy. Yeah, it's class. And when you put that throughout the house, and it's the strings, and you've got Nat's voice, and it's just regal.